finance piece, and then there is an operating lease.
There are internal auditors everywhere. Then how did that Vijay Mallya fraud even happen?
Gross profit will give me the sales.
Are internal auditors as independent as external auditors?
Let's now talk about corporate governance. To put corporate governance in very simple words, remember your school days where there were set of rules and regulations as to how you have to behave? Same way, corporate governance was introduced in the company because of lot of scandals, scams, etc. that happened in the early 2000s. Like I said, the Enron scandal, where the management was not working in the best interest of the shareholders, led to the introduction of corporate governance. Corporate governance was anyways there from a really long time, but the importance of it became more after these financial scandals that happened in the past. So what is corporate governance? Corporate governance, in simple words, they are set of policies, procedures, rules, regulations that the company has to adhere to. This is a way how things are directed and controlled in the organization. So what are certain things that we have to maintain in corporate governance? One, there has to be separation of ownership and management. Two, people have to be different. One person cannot be doing the same thing, because that's when there is a scope for any fraudulent activity to take place. So there has to be separation of ownership and management. Earlier, we saw that there is this concept of agency theory, right? What happens in agency theory? There is a principal and then there is an agent. The agent works on behalf of the principal, and the principal is the one who employs the agent. Why did corporate governance come into picture? Because there was an agency problem. It's because the agents were not working in the best interest of the shareholders. That's why the importance of corporate governance grew over a period of time. We all have dreamt of becoming CEOs, CFOs of companies, right? So that's where we have to realize that these two are different people. The chairman and CEO. These are two different people and they have to be different. Chairman is the one who manages the board, whereas the CEO is the one who handles the day-to-day operations of the business. So, clear distinction of ownership and management, segregation of duties are the key aspects of corporate governance. Not just this, when we talk about corporate governance, it also plays a very important role in your internal controls and risk management. So to put it in simple words, these are set of policies, procedures, practices that the company has to adhere to in order to prevent and mitigate the risk for a company. Moving on. Let's talk about stock listing. So we all know a public company has to be registered with the stock exchange, right? And the moment you register with the stock exchange, you will have lot of things to adhere to. We're familiar that once the company is listed in the stock exchange, it has to, you have to audit the companies. There are so many set of rules and regulations. You have to publish the financial statements every year. You have to make sure that there is transparency in the company. And also you have to clearly mention what is the corporate governance codes and what are the social responsibilities. So that's about stock listing requirements. Not very important in the exam point of view, but you guys need to know what it actually does. Apart from that, you have measuring achievements of corporate financial objectives. So more on this we will be discussing in chapter 19. So here when they say about financial objectives, we are focusing more on the ratios. And when I say ratios, you all know that ratios is simply a mathematical expression, right? There's a numerator and there's a denominator. And how do we build ratios? We pick up the line items from your balance sheet and your P&L account. So ratios again can be bifurcated into various categories. It can be bifurcated into liquidity ratios, profitability ratios, activity ratios. So liquidity ratios will tell you what is the liquidity of the company. Do they have cash flow problems? Are they able to meet their obligations, their short-term obligations on time? So we're going to discuss in detail about this in chapter 19. Profitability ratios, which is very important, because this is going to tell you the financial position of the company. So here we're going to discuss about your return on investment, return on capital employed, and various interesting financial ratios and investor ratios. That is, we can call it as market ratios. You as an investor, will you blindly invest in any company? Of course not, right? You will go through the financial statements. You will check how much is the PE ratio, you'll check how much is the earnings per share. You'll also have a look at how much dividend the company is paying. So as an investor, what are those ratios that you will look for? All of those things are covered in your market ratios. So that's about your ratio analysis. So ratios is basically going to tell you about the financial health of the company. Like if you go for a medical checkup, you get the medical report, right? What your glucose levels are, diabetes, cholesterol. Similarly, ratios are going to tell you what is the financial health of the company, and it lets the investors make better decisions.